intention for Mass today is for Patrick and Leah Geologo for their wedding anniversary. Patrick and Leah. Are Patrick and Leah here? Nope. Okay, so Patrick and Leah, would pray for them. I will be praying the intention for the deceased members of the Dominicans. So deceased members.
Son of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of Christ our Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And which is the cathedral of all the cathedrals of the world?
Okay.
Church whose feast day we celebrate today, the Church of St. John Lateran. The first cathedral of the city of Rome. And it became the cathedral of the cathedrals. So we pray for all cathedrals, communities throughout the world, especially here in Los Angeles, and for all our catechumens on this great feast of the center of baptism and reformation and counter-reform in the church. So for all these needs, we pray. We pray especially for those who are homeless and out on the streets this day. They might experience the warmth, gentleness, and the invitation of the Christian community. I confess
that you, my brothers and sisters, that I have taken sin in my thoughts and my words, and what I have done, and what I have been doing, in my fault, in my fault, in my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, of all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will.
We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God, who from living and chosen stones, prepare an eternal dwelling for your majesty, increase your church. In your church, the spirit of grace you have bestowed, so that by a new growth your faithful people may build up the heavenly kingdom, the heavenly Jerusalem. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east, for the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the southern side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside by the north gate, and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the southern side. He said to me, "This water flows into the eastern district down upon the Arabah and empties into the sea, the salt waters, which it makes fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes to the sea, shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail. Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine." The word of the Lord. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken, and mountains plunge into the depth of the sea.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
The waters of the river and the sea of the Lord, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building, according to the grace of God given to me. Like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it. For no one can lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews said, this temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in three days? They were speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the words Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
About the time when you've been someplace really important and people were all very much in awe of the place, but they missed the point of the place. They were so busy taking in the sight of the place that they lost the meaning of the place. This is what happens in the temple today, in the gospel. Jesus is looking for the meaning of the place, not just the beauty of the place. He's not just driving out cattle and sheep and oxen and birds from a part of the temple where they didn't belong. It was that the hearts that make up the temple were not open. They were closed down. And he's saying, this is my Father's dwelling. You have to open your hearts up to him. Then you'll understand that this is all about this temple. Whether we celebrate Mass out here under the sky somewhat and freezing our tushies off, or we're in the nice, big, pretty church with central air, what's the meaning of the place? Is it good for us to be out there, in there, comfortable and unaware of what it's like for those who are poor and homeless? Isn't it, as we complain about how cold it is, isn't it a good thing that we think about, reflect about the people for whom they have to go every day to church, to the store, from a tent, if they're lucky? I worked for a while with the mentally ill homeless when I was finishing up my MSW. Utah. And I remember one
one gentleman who came to our outreach program for the homeless, and he was an elderly black man and schizophrenic, and he was too afraid to come into our program because he couldn't handle the crowds of people. And by trying to plead with him to come in and get some services from us that he needed, and I'll be glad we did. He just looked at me, he just shook his head and walked away. And I just felt broken at that moment. And there was the very kind of person that we were there for, community mental health and the veterans program. All of us were there working. And he could not come in because he could not tolerate it. There were too many people in there fighting him. And I used all the techniques that they taught me, and none of them worked. We have to have that part of our heart broken open to be temples of the Lord, to realize how we stand empty-handed, not very capable, and yet Christ builds us up as stones into a temple, something beautiful, but also something that has great meaning behind it. Not just a pretty church, a pretty building. As they said of one of my cousins once, she wanted a church wedding, preferably brick and Gothic. Not just that, but something deeper than that. Not just a place we stop by to get our cars blessed and our babies baptized, but something deeper. Christ is calling us today, and the cathedral of all the cathedrals, St. John Lateran, not an ugly church either, by the way, beautiful church, but a church with very humble beginnings. In the 3rd and 4th century at the Lateran Palace, the Lateran family on the Lateran Hill, and it was taken in by the first free bishop after the persecutions had ended. And it was there that they then began to build up the Christian community after the end of the persecutions. Simple and still going. That community is still a lively community. So too our community, diminished as we are here this morning because of COVID and any number of things, and yet here we are. And we recognize what really counts, the presence of the Lord building us up into the body of Christ, a cathedral, a temple worthy of himself. In peace we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To Patrick and Leah Diologo on their wedding anniversary, the Lord would bless them with many years of happiness together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of the Order of Preachers, for all the laity, sisters, nuns, and friars, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the members of our families who have died over the past year. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the brothers and sisters mentioned in the school, those who were buried from this church this past year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, all who lead us in faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray. O God, who are pleased to call your church the bride, grant that the people that serve your name may revere you, love you, and follow you, and may be led by you to attain your promises in heaven. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. accept, we pray, O Lord, the offering made here, and grant that by those who seek your favor may receive in this place the power of the sacraments and the answer to their prayers. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in your benevolence you are pleased to dwell in this home, house of prayer, in order to perfect us as the temple of the Holy Spirit, supported by the perpetual help of your grace and resplendent with the glory of life acceptable to you. Year by year you sanctify the church, the bride of Christ, foreshadowing in this invisible buildings, so that rejoicing as the mother of countless children, she may be given her place in your heavenly glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. And to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, to make gracious and make holy these gifts that we have set aside for you, that we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and, giving you thanks and praise, he gave the chalice to his disciples and said the blessing. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, that will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and looking as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Baptist, St. John the Evangelist, St. John the Beloved Disciple, and all your beloved, all your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, our Holy Father Dominic, our Sister Catherine Siena, St. Lorenzo Ruiz, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world.
Be pleased to confirm
in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, especially those whose names are mentioned on the altar, the envelopes on the altar for all souls, those whose names are mentioned on the prayer scroll, and all Dominicans, the entire Dominican family who have died. In your compassion, O merciful, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Forever and ever. Forever. Alleluia. Forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence to the Father, in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our days. In your mercy, keep us free from all of our fears and our anxieties, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another the sign of Christ's peace.
On your stay,
qui vois peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On your stay, qui vois peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On your stay, qui vois peccata mundi.
I believe that you are present.
I believe that you are present.
In the most holy sacrament.
In the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things.
I love you above all things.
And I desire to receive you into my soul.
And I desire to receive you into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment.
Since I cannot at this moment.
Receive you sacramentally.
Receive you sacramentally.
Come with me spiritually into my heart.
Come with me spiritually into my heart.
I embrace you as if you were already there.
I embrace you as if you were already there.
United States and the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
let us pray.
chose to foreshadow of it for us, the heavenly Jerusalem, to the sign of your church on earth, grant, we pray, that by partaking of this sacrament, we may be made the temple of your grace, and may enter the dwelling place of your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In peace and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, descend upon you all and remain with you forever.
Amen.
And go forth to be the temple of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Just a reminder, on Wednesday, our Mass starts at 9. However, we're going to have rosary for our nation, which starts at 8. Thank you.